All right, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Pointers with the Pros. I am Kaylin, and I am joined here by our business development manager, Jesus, who is here to talk to us today about one of our newest products. And we're really excited about this because we kind of sort of had something similar in the past, but it's completely revamped, and that is our DB500 offshore system. And the reason that we've invited Jesus here today is because he actually is an expert in this industry. So I would love first, Jesus, for you to kind of introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about your background in this specific industry.
Of course. Thank you
for
having me. Well, I've been in the oil and gas industry for more than 15 years in different roles, right? I started being an offshore hand and then spent a lot of time doing marketing, commercial work and corporate work, right?
And so if you're someone who is in this industry and you could talk to them and tell them why this product would be for them, what would you say?
So a lot of what happens is when it comes to preparing surfaces, I mean, first of all, in oil and gas, everything's steel, right? Everything is steel plate that needs to be maintained, that is exposed to very, aggressive environments, right? Highly corrosive environments. Yeah. And a lot of surface prep and paint jobs have to be done, right? What happens is that sandblasting, it's a great solution, right? It leaves the surface that you need, right, to do that next paint work, but it's very aggressive with the environment, right? Mm. So you need to stop operations, and you cannot be doing other things on the rig while you're
with
sandblasting.
With dry blasting,
right?
Right, okay.
So
what are they doing?
Well, they just work with manual grinders, right? Scrapers, and they do a lot of manual work, right? It's hard. It's expensive. It's expensive because you need to mobilize people, right? And it's very slow. And it's extremely cumbersome to the type of work, right? So a lot of times, instead of having a recurring program, right, you wait until things are really, really in bad shape before you go back and stop operations, right? And you take the platform, to dry dock and do a large maintenance every 5 or 6 years, right?
So would you say for the most part, it looks like now people are, it's almost like minimal maintenance that requires a lot of effort and really isn't making a ton of progress. And then they're having to pull the rig once it's a complete rust bucket. And then they're having to maybe do traditional sandblasting once there's no workers on there for worker safety. Is that?
So that's a lot of what happens. Yes. It's not, and of course, different companies have different protocols, and then you can see a little of everything. But yes, what happens is that a lot of the maintenance that could have been done early, a small cost, right, ends up being done late at a higher cost, right? The urgent takes from the important, if you will, when it comes to, right?
Right.
And then you also have things like inspection, right? You need to perhaps to inspect wells or to do large inspections. It's hard. You need to bring people, you need to bring the crews, right? You cannot do it with the rig hands because you need to bring a special team to do all that additional work, which is very, very, very labor intensive.
And so why would dustless blasting be a solution for these?
Mainly because if you can get better efficiency than what you would achieve with the manual, with needle guns and tools like that, right?
Right.
Without affecting a large area, if that was part of the toolkit of a rig, all of a sudden you enable a lot of maintenance activities as part of the daily operation. In the angle for our product is that, right? It's all of a sudden you have a tool that will give you the same, if not better, performance than a method that you can only use when everything is
shut down,
right? But you can do it all the time.
Right. And now, after working with a few of these rigging companies, you have put it in a way, you've reconfigured it into a new model that works best for them. And so what does that new model look like?
So it's essentially our DB500, right? Mm-hmm. In the past, we had a similar solution, right? A DB1500, we still offer it. We still have that unit, right? Which is a larger blast put, right?
Yeah.
And the intention for that has to go into large maintenance programs, right? With the DB500, this is a smaller thing, right? You have a 1 hour of run rate, but it's a lot easier. It's a little easier to take it to and from the rig, and it requires a lot less footprint, right? It's a smaller package, right?
And why is that important, the smaller
because
footprint?
Because space is a premium.
Okay.
Facility, right? When you talk about jack-up rigs or floaters, right? This routine, everything is small. And space is really a premium, right?
Okay.
So if you can find something that you can put in different places, right? And move around, right? Or land in the rig and then move around, it's a feature that, that really adds a lot of, gives a lot of optionality.
Right.
So we developed this with the 500 blast pot, right? We packaged it into a frame, into a basket.
Yeah.
To transport it, right? With all the certifications for lifting pad ice and all the stuff, and also the ability to bring it in and out of the basket, right?
Mm.
So you can transport it, move it, lift it, put it in, drop it into the rig. And then whether you decide to just operate like such in the frame or take it out of the basket, you have that optionality, right?
Well, this is pretty unique because I feel like this project specifically has been a true partnership with a few different rigging companies who have said, hey, we think your product could be a solution for us, but I think it needs to look more like this. It needs to operate like this, as far as really just the whole planning, like you said, of putting it on a rig, what's that look like, the spacing of it, and being able to move the blast pot in and out of that basket. So that's something that I'm really excited about, just because we've gotten a lot of feedback from real companies who plan on using this. And one of these companies that you've been working with directly actually had you guys come out to one of their rigs, bring it on site, and see, you know, what that looks like. Can you talk a little bit about how that experience was? And you can be vague, but just, you know, how they plan on using it, were they happy with it, and, you know, what their feedback was?
We talked about it. Okay, this is the tool. This is what we can do with it. They came to see it. They really liked what they saw. They said, okay, you know what, we should probably take it and do a field test with it, right? Before we got to the field test, we also did a lot of design and a lot of work ourselves. I mean, we talked back and forth about what were the features that it would be nice to add, right? And I think that's a really cool thing about our company, the fact that we are able to respond and to add features and package, which is essentially the same product, but in different formats that really enables, you know, different use cases.
Yeah.
So we went out there, right? And we went into the shipyard and shipped the unit and did the test, right?
Yeah.
It went very well. We didn't have any issues whatsoever with the air capacity that they had in a standard jackup rig. We had water, right? Did a couple of tests because we had crushed glass. And then we also wanted to look to explore the pyroxene
media,
which is the new media that we're pushing to market, right? A little bit more aggressive, different anchoring profile and all those things, right? We started with crushed glass. Crushed glass, see what it does, good performance. We found out that there were places where they had a lot of rust, right? You have the layers of paint and then layers of rust underneath. And it's just because, as I said, it's hard to keep up with maintenance in a very corrosive environment, in an asset that needs to keep running. So it did what it needed to do, and they were super happy. We worked with them developing work instructions, right? Helping with JSH, with the Jeff Safety Analysis, right? Say, okay, well, these are the potential risks, right? All those things are things that these companies, right, consider seriously, right, and look at all the potential risks. And working with a customer that's concerned and that asks those type of questions, right, is slightly different from what we have done in the past with other type of customers, right, that use it safely but that don't necessarily need to document all those processes and every single thing that occurs, right?
Right. And so I feel like a lot of people don't know this, but our machine can do both. It can blast dry and it can blast wet. But for these rigging companies, obviously, they're going to be blasting wet.
Yeah, I mean, the value proposition for them, one of the key components is the fact that you don't have to stop operations all around. You're not going to, you know, fill the platform or the rig with a cloud of
dust.
That is not going to let anyone do anything around,
with
right?
The
containment is very easy, right? Mm-hmm. The cleanup is also easy. The materials is environmentally safe, right? So you really don't have to do, you know, a lot to enable into a crew to go in and work, right?
Right.
One of the considerations that they had is, I mean, after working for a few minutes, right, with a flexible hose, right, in the nozzle, if you want to do some work on a floor, right, you have to be, you know,
hunched over
in just a, and that's tiresome, and that's hard for folks to do, right? So we worked in developing a rigid extension, right? With a little rolling plate at one of the ends, right?
So that they
can actually sit in the nozzle and just work on floors, right? Or work on walls.
No, that's right? Awesome.
Small little things, right? It's just a piece of hardware. It's essentially a new product that we developed as part of this project.
Yeah.
Right? But it's also a testament of the type of things that we can do.
Yeah.
Right? When we're presented with market opportunities, right? That requires small tweaks or addition of features, right, to our existing product line.
Right. Because you clearly, I mean, with your background, have seen a need for this for a very long time. We know it's everywhere, and it's going to be a very sought after system for an industry that just hasn't had a solution like this before. And so.
Exactly. If we know it works in offshore rig, there's no reason why it was not going to work in a ship.
Yeah.
Right. And all of a sudden you become part of a ship, ship's maintenance program, right?
Yeah.
Which is another market, right? It may need slightly different tweaks. It may, the right fit would be maybe a smaller last spot size, but we have all those options. So that's kind of the project that we're in, right? Trying to understand better what are the specific needs of a specific use cases and see how can we.
We got you covered.
That's exactly right.
All right, y'all. Well, we are very excited to launch this new DB500 offshore unit. So if you are interested or you have any questions, feel free to reach out. You can call us directly or visit dustlessblasting.com. But Jesus, thanks so much for joining us. This was awesome, and I'm super excited about it.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Yeah.